أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. صدق الله العظيم.
نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم، أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. حم والكتاب المبين. إنا جعلناه قرآنا عربيا لعلكم تعقلون، وإنه في أم الكتاب لدينا لعلي حكيم. صدق الله العظيم. Of the Hamim series surahs, now remain two more pairs, Surat al-Zukhruf and Surat al-Dukhan. They are a pair, both start with these words, Hamim wal Kitab al-Mubin. Then Surat al-Jasiyah and Surat al-Ahqaf. They are a pair, they start with the words, Hamim tanzeelul kitab min Allahil Aziz al-Hakim. In these four surahs, the main subject we have discussed is Tawheed again. But here both aspects of Tawheed, they are discussed. The theoretical aspect, or Tawheed fil Aqeedah, and the practical aspect of Tawheed, Tawheed fil Amal. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Hameem wal-Kitab al-Mubeen. By the book that is self-evident and manifest. Now here, this is the oath that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taken. But what is the subject on which this oath has been taken? It is mahzoof, it is understood. So we have to read here the same as we find in Surah Yasin. Yasin wal Quran al Hakim, innaka lamin al mursaleen. So that is muqtab alayh over here also. Hameem wal kitab al mubeen, innaka lamin al mursaleen. By this book, which is self-evident and manifest, O Muhammad, you are, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, definitely a messenger of Allah. وَإِنَّهُ فِي أُمِّ الْكِتَابِ لَدَيْنَا لَعَلِيٌّ حَكِيمٌ. And this book is in the mother book, which is with us, and which is very high and full of wisdom. Now this is أُمُّ الْكِتَابِ. This Quran, as I said before also at some time, these are the copies of Quran, the attested copies. Real Quran is fi ummil kitab, in the mother book, which is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Or fi lawhim mahfuz, the protected and preserved tablet. Or fi kitabim maknoon, the hidden book. So these are the three, you know, places in Quran where it is said the real Quran is there. وَإِنَّهُ فِي أُمِّ الْكِتَابِ لَدَيْنَا لَعَلِيٌّ حَكِيمٌ. And verily, this Qur'an is in the mother book, the most fundamental book, which is with us, لَدَيْنَا. And it is very high and full of wisdom. أَفَنَضْرِبُ عَنْكُمُ الذِّكْرَ صَفْحًا أَنْ كُنْتُمْ قَوْمًا مُسْرِفِينَ. Shall we then take away the admonition from you altogether because you are a transgressing people. Because you are not accepting it, you are rejecting it, you are mocking at it. So, should we take it away from you? No. وَكَمْ أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ نَبِيٍّ فِي الْأَوَّلِينَ. And how many a prophet we send among the ancients. وَمَا يَاتِهِمْ مِنْ نَبِيٍّ إِلَّا كَانُوا بِهِ يَسْتَهْزِئُونَ. And there never came any prophet to any people, but they mocked at him. فَأَغْلَقْنَا أَشَدَّ مِنْهُمْ بَطْشًا. Then we destroyed those who were very much more powerful than these people. وَبَذَا مَثَلُ الْأَوَّلِينَ. And the examples of the ancients have already gone forth. وَلَئِنْ سَأَلْتَهُمْ مَنْ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ. And if you ask him, Who created the heavens and the earth? لَيَقُولُنَّ They will definitely say, خَلَقَهُنَّ الْعَزِيزُ الْعَلِيمُ They have been created by that who is almighty and knower of everything. الَّذِي جَعَلَ لَكُمُ الْأَرْضَ مَهْدًا Who has made the earth for you a cradle. وَجَعَلَ لَكُمْ فِيهَا سُبُلًا And he has made there in paths and ways for you, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَحْتَدُونَ So that you can reach your destinations. وَالَّذِي نَزَلَ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَاءً بِقَدَرٍ And it is he who sends down water from the heaven in due measure. فَأَنْشَرْنَا بِهِ بَلْدَةً مَيْتًا And then we revive thereby a land which was already dead. كَذَلِكَ تُخْرَجُونَ In the same way you will be taken out from the earth in resurrection. وَالَّذِي خَلَقَ الْأَزْوَاجَ كُلَّهَا And it is who has created the pairs of all things. وَجَعَلَ لَكُمْ مِنَ الْفُلْكِ وَالْأَنْعَامِ مَا تَرْكَبُونَ And he has given you in the form of ships and cattle on which you ride. لِتَسْتَوُوا عَلَىٰ ظُهُورِهِ So that you should mount upon their backs. ثُمَّ تَذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةَ رَبِّكُمْ And then you should remember the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on you is أَسْتَوَيْتُمْ عَلَيْهِ When you have settled down on them. وَتَقُولُوا And then you say, سبحان الذي سخر لنا هذا وما كنا له مقرنين Glorified is he who has subjected all this to us and we ourselves were not capable to do it. وَإِنَّا إِلَىٰ رَبِّنَا لَمُنْقَلِبُونَ And then finally we have to return to our Lord. وَجَعَلُوا لَهُ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ جُزْءًا And they have declared some of his own servants as a part of him. Now when somebody says he is son of God, now son, where from he comes? He comes from the sperm of the father. The sperm was a part of the body of the father. It means whosoever is an offspring is a part of the person of the father. So that way they are claiming, as if they are claiming, that they are the part of his person. وَيَعْلُونَهُ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ جُزًا إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَكَفُورٌ مُبِينٌ Verily, insan is very ungrateful. أَمِ اتَّخَذَ مِمَّا يَخْلُقُ بَنَاتٍ Has he, that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, taken unto himself out of what he created daughters? وَأَصْفَاكُمْ بِالْبَنِينَ And he has preferred you for sons. وَإِذَا بُشِّرَ أَحَدُهُمْ بِمَا ضَرَبَ لِلرَّحْمَنِ مَثَلًا And when any one of them is given the glad tidings of what they are striking the similitude for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ظَلَّ وَجْهُهُ His face becomes darkened, مَسْوَدًا ظَلَّ وَجْهَهُ مُسْوَدًا وَهُوَ كَزِيمٌ And he is choked with grief. أَوَمَنْ يُنَشَّعُ فِي الْحِلْيَةِ Has that come to me who is reared among ornaments, the female childs, they play with ornaments. وَهُوَ فِي الْخِسَامِ غَيْرُ مُبِينَ And in arguing, he or she is not very clear. وَجَعَلُوا الْمَلَائِكَةَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ عِبَادُ الرَّحْمَنِ نَاسَ And they have said that the angels, who are the servants of the compassionate, that they are females. أَشْتَهِدُوا خَلْقَهُمْ Did they witness their creation? سَتُبْتَبُ شَهَادَتُهُمْ وَيُسَلُونَ So their testimony will be recorded and then they will be questioned on the day of judgment. How did you say that the angels were females? وَقَالُوا لَوْ شَاءَ الرَّحْمَنُ مَا عَبَدْنَاهُمْ And they say, if the compassionate had desired or willed, we would not have worshipped these gods. مَا لَهُمْ بِذَلِكَ مِنْ عِلْمٍ They don't have any knowledge for that. إِنُمْ إِلَّا يَخْرُسُونَ They are only guessing. أَمْ آتَيْنَاهُمْ كِتَابًا مِّن قَبْلِهِ فَهُمْ بِهِ مُسْتَبْسِكُونَ Have we given them a book before this book? So they are clinging to it. Do they have any book? بَلْ قَالُوا إِنَّا وَجَدْنَا عَبَانَ عَلَىٰ أُمَّتٍ They themselves said, we found our forefathers on a religion, acting on a religion. وَإِنَّا عَلَىٰ أَصَارِهِمْ مُحْتَدُونَ And we are being guided by their footsteps. They don't claim that they have a book. Any revealed scriptures were given to them. وَكَذَلِكَ مَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ قَبْلِكَ فِي قَرِيَةٍ مِّن نَذِيرٍ And in the same way, We never sent in any city or township before you a messenger, a warner, illa kala mutrafuha, but the affluent people of that town said, inna vajadna abana ala ummatin. Verily, we have found our forefathers on the religion. Vaina ala asarihim muqtadun. And we are following their footsteps. Kala avalojyatakum bi ahda mimma vajadtum alayhi abakum. Now the messenger said, although I might have brought to you something which is more guided, more guiding than what you found your forefathers on. Kalu inna bima ursiltum bihi kafirun. Then they said it plainly. Okay, listen. We surely disbelieve in what you have been sent with. I declare our rejection of what you are saying. Fantaqamna minhum. Then we took the revenge from them. Fanzur kaifa kana aqibatul mukazzibin. So see, what was the end of these who belied? What was the end of the people of Nuh and Hud and Saleh and so on? وَإِذْ قَالَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ لِأَبِيهِ وَقَوْمِهِ. And recall, when Ibrahim said to his father and his nation, إِنَّنِي بَرَاءٌ مِمَّا تَعْبُدُونَ. I am not in the least connected with those whom you are worshipping. إِلَّا الَّذِي فَتَرَنِي. Except the one who has created me. فَإِنَّهُ سَيَهْدِينَ. And he will definitely show me the right path. وَجَعَلَهَا كَلِمَةٌ بَاقِيَةٌ. And he made it a lasting word, fi aqibihi, in his posterity. What does it mean? To his progeny he said, don't believe in anyone else except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ. So that if sometimes they go astray, they can come back. If that word remains there, la ilaha illallah. بَلْ مَتَّعْتُ هَاُولَاءِ وَعَبَاهُمْ. But I let these people and their fathers enjoy comfort, حَتَّى جَاهُمُ الْحَقِّ. So that when the truth came, Rasulun Mubeen, and a very clear messenger came to them, وَلَمَّا جَاهُمُ الْحَقِّ. And when the truth came to them, قَالُوا هَذَا سِحْرٌ. They said, this is sorcery. وَإِنَّا بِهِ كَافِرُونَ. And we disbelieve in it. وَقَالُوا لَوْلَا نُزِّلَ هَذَا الْقُرْآنُ عَلَىٰ رَجُلٍ مِنَ الْقَرْيَتَيْنِ عَظِيمٍ. And they said, why was not this Quran sent down upon some great person from these two cities? These two cities, they were twin cities, so to say. Just as we have in Pakistan, Rawalpindi and Islamabad are twin cities. So Makkah and Taif were the twin cities, because people of Makkah had properties in Taif. Taif was, so to say, the hill station for the people of Makkah. In the summer they used to go there. It is high altitude, very good weather. So actually these are the two very big cities of Hijaz. So what they said, if Allah had to send a messenger, he could choose a big chieftain, a wealthy person, a person who has, you know, so much wealth with him. From these two cities, so many people were there. Who could have chosen someone? Great person. وَقَالُوا لَوْلَا نُزِّلَ هَذَا الْقُرْآنُ عَلَىٰ رَجُلٍ مِنَ الْخَرْيَتَيْنِ عَظِيمٍ. أَهُمْ يَقْسِمُونَ رَحْمَةَ رَبِّكَ. Will they distribute the mercy of your Lord? This nabuwah and risalah, this mercy. That is why I told you that this institution of prophethood and messengerhood of Allah has reached in the person of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, its climax. And that is why we say, لَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. The rahmah, the mercy of Allah has reached its zenith in the person of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So now will they distribute, will they decide to whom this mercy should go? نَحْنُ قَسَمْنَا بَيْنَهُمْ عَيْشَتَهُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. We have distributed among them their livelihood for the life of this world. وَرَفَعْنَا بَعْضَهُمْ فَوْقَ بَعْضٍ دَرَجَاتٍ. And we have raised some of them in rank above others. سُخْرِيًا لَيَتَّخِذَ بَعْضُهُمْ بَعْضًا سُخْرِيًا. So that some of them can take service from others, can employ them as servants. وَرَحْمَةُ رَبِّكَ خَيْرٌ مِمَّا يَجْمَعُونَ. But the mercy of your Lord is much better than what they are holding and what they are amassing. This mercy of Allah is the revelation which has come to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. وَلَوْلَا يَكُونَ النَّاسُ أُمَّةً وَاحِدَةً. And if there was not the possibility that whole humanity and mankind would become an evil community, لَجَعَلْنَا لِمَنْ يَكْفُرُ الرَّحْمَانِ, we would have given those people who reject Rahman, who disbelieve in Rahman, لِبْيُوتِهِمْ, for their houses, سُقُفًا مِّن فِزَّةً, roofs made of silver, وَبَعَارِجَةً, and the stairs also, عَلَيْهَا يَزْهَرُونَ, on which they ascend. وَلِبْيُوتِهِمْ أَبْوَابًا, and also for their houses, doors of silver, وَسُرُرًا, and beds of silver, عَلَيْهَا يَتَّكِئُونَ, on which they recline, وَزُخْرُفًا, or not only of silver, but also of gold. But what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to say, that all these things have no value in our eyes. We could give to any kafir everything here. But if we give all the kafirs all these things, then all the people will become kafirs. So that is why we are not giving them. But these things have no importance in our eyes. There is a saying of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala holds whatever is in this world, the whole wealth, equal to a mosquito's wing, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would not have given even a draught of water to any kafir. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows that these things are meaningless, valueless. They have no value in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In kullu dhalika lamma mata'ul hayati dunya. And then, even then, all this would have been only a passing comfort for this life of this world. وَالْآخِرَةُ عِنْدَ رَبِّكَ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. While the akhirah, the hereafter, which is with your Lord, is much better for those who fear God. وَمَنْ يَعْشُ عَنْ ذِكْرِ الرَّحْمَانِ. And whosoever blinds himself to the admonition of the compassionate, نُقَيَّزْ لَهُ شَيْطَانًا. We appoint for him a Satan, فَهُوَ قَرِينَ, and he becomes his friend or comrade. This we have read before also. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has, with every human being, he has appointed a Satan, a jinn. وَإِنَّهُمْ لَيْسَدُّونَ عَمَنِ السَّبِيلِ. And these Satans, they bar them from the right way. وَيَحْسَبُونَ أَنَّهُمْ مُهْتَدُونَ. And they are thinking that they are the rightly guided. They are on the right path. حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءَنَا. Till that time, when they will come to us, قَالَ يَا لَيْتَ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَكَ بُعْدَ الْمَشْرِقَيْنِ. Then the human will say to his jinn or Satan companion, would that there had been between you and me the distance of the two east. So evil is the comrade. فَبِئْسَ الْقَرِينِ. So evil are you, have you been to me as a comrade. You turned me away from the right path. You led me astray. And as a result, now I am going to be thrown in the fire of hell. وَلَنْ يَنْفَعَكُمُ الْيَوْمَ إِذْ ظَلَمْتُمْ أَنَّكُمْ فِي الْعَذَابِ مُشْتَرِكُونَ. And this is not going to profit you today, when you were evildoers, that you will be now sharers in this chastisement. You and your Satan both will be in the fire of hell. أَفَأَنْتَ تُسْمِعُ السُّمَّ. O Muhammad, can you make the deaf to hear? أَوْ تَهْدِي الْعُمْيَ. Or you can guide the blind. وَمَنْ كَانَ فِي ذَلَالِ مُبِينَ. Or the one who is in manifest error. فَإِمَّا نَزَبَنَّا بِكَ. So it is also possible that we will take you away. فَإِنَّا مِنُّ مُنْتَقِبُونَ. But then we shall take the revenge from them. أَوْ نُرِيَنَّكَ الَّذِي وَعَدْنَاهُمْ. Or we can show to you in your own lifetime what we have promised them. فَإِنَّا عَلَيْهِمْ مُقْتَدِرُونَ. We are very powerful and we command. We can do this. فَاسْتَمْسِكْ بِالَّذِي أُوْحِيَ إِلَيْكَ. So cling and hold fast to what has been revealed to you. This is the source of strength. To hold fast to Quran. وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا. اُتْلُ مَا أُوْحِيَ إِلَيْكَ مِنْ كِتَابِ رَبِّكَ لَا مُبَدِّلَ لِكَلِمَاتِهِ. وَاتْلُ مَا أُوْحِيَ إِلَيْكَ مِنَ الْكِتَابِ وَأَقِمِ الصَّلَاةِ. All time you know, this has been coming, this command to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his companions. فَاسْتَمْسِكْ بِالَّذِي أُوْحِيَ إِلَيْكَ. So hold fast and cling to that which has been revealed to you. إِنَّكَ عَلَىٰ صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. and rest assured that you are on the right path, straight path. وَإِنَّهُ لَذِكْرٌ لَكَ وَلِقَوْمِكَ. And this Quran is an admonition for you and your nation, your people. وَسَوْفَ تُسْأَلُونَ. And after some time you will be questioned. وَسَأَلْ مَنْ أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ قَبْلِكَ بِرُسُلِنَا. Just ask those whom we sent before you as messengers. أَجْعَلْنَا مِنْ دُونِ الرَّحْمَانِ آلِهَةً يُعْبَدُونَ. Did we ever appoint gods besides Rahman who should be worshipped? Has it ever been in any revealed scripture, has it been the teaching of any messenger of Allah that there is some god or gods besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Ask them. وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا مُوسَى بِآيَاتِنَا إِلَىٰ فِرْعَوْنَ وَمَلَئِهِ. And we had sent Musa with our signs to Fir'aun and his chiefs. فَقَالَ إِنِّي رَسُولُ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. And he said, I am the messenger of the Lord of all the worlds. فَلَمَّا جَاءَهُمْ بِآيَاتِنَا إِذَا هُمْ مِنْهَا يَضْحَكُونَ. When he came to them with our signs, behold, they started laughing on him. وَمَا نُرِيهِمْ مِنْ آيَةٍ لَا هِيَ أَكْبَرُ مِنْ أُخْتِهَا. And we showed them the signs, and each one which followed was greater than the one which was preceded, the sister. وَأَخَذْنَاهُمْ بِالْعَذَابِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ. And then we sent on them smaller chastisements so that they return and they turn to ourselves. وَقَالُوا يَا أَيُّهَا السَّاحِرُ. And whenever any affliction came to them, عذاب الأدنى, قَالُوا, they said, يَا أَيُّهَا السَّاحِرُ. Now they are addressing Musa as Sahir. O sorcerer, O magician, ادعو لنا ربك. Pray to your Lord for us. بما عهد عندك. For you have a covenant with him. إننا لمهتدون. Now if this affliction is taken away from us, then we shall accept your da'wah, you shall accept you as messenger, and we shall be rightly guided. فلما كشفنا عنه العذاب. When we removed from them that chastisement, إذا هم ينكسون, they broke their promise. They went back. ونادى فرعون في قومه. And proclaimed Fir'aun in his nation. قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ أَلَيْسَ لِي مُلْكُ مِصْرِ. Oh my people, is not the government of Egypt under me? This is the political shirk. Whosoever claims to be sovereign, he claims to be God. Because sovereignty belongs to God alone. Whosoever claims. Whether he is one person, Fir'aun and Namrud, or the so-called common people, masses, sovereignty of the people, common people, well, it is shirk of first order. And there is no difference between monarchy and democracy. In both of them being shirk of the first order. وَنَادَى فِرْعَوْنُ فِي قَوْمِهِ قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ أَلَيْسَ لِي مُلْكُ مِصْرَ. وَهَذِهِ الْأَنْهَارُ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِي. And these canals or these rivers are flowing underneath me. This is the literal translation. And some of the Mufassirin say that under the palaces, you know, he had the rivers and canals flowing. But I don't think this is the meaning. The meaning is that the whole irrigation system is under my control. Because, you know, the economy of Egypt depended upon agriculture. Agriculture depended upon water. Water was coming from Nile. And from the Nile it was the irrigation. And all the irrigation was controlled by the government. To give water to whom and not to whom. This was decision taken by the government. So this all thing is under me. All the resources are under my control. أَفَلَا تُبْصِرُونَ. Don't you see? أَمَنَا خَيْرٌ مِّنْ هَذَا أَلَّذِي هُوَ مُهِينٌ. Am I not better than this person, Musa? Huwa muheen. He is contemptible. Wala yakadu yubin. And he cannot express himself clearly. Falawla ulqiya alayhi aswiratun min zahabin. So why were not the bracelets of gold cast upon him? Aw jaa ma'ahul malaikatu muqtarinin. Or the angels would have come with him as attendants. If he is the messenger of Allah, the God of all the kingdoms and all the worlds, then these things should have come with him. فَاسْتَخَفَّ قَوْمَهُ فَاطَعُوهُ. So he made his people lose their sense and they obeyed him. إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا قَوْمًا فَاسِقِينَ. Surely they were a transgressing people. فَلَمَّا أَسَفُونَا, when they angered us, انتقمنا منهم, we took revenge from them. فَأَغْرَقْنَاهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ, and we drowned them all together. فَجَعَلْنَاهُمْ صَلَفًا. Now we have made them stories of the past, وَمَثَلًا لِلْآخِرِينَ, an example for the coming generations, later generations. وَلَمَّا ضُرِبَ ابْنُ مَرْيَمَ مَثَلًا إِذَا قَوْمُكَ مِنْهُ يَصِدُّونَ. When an example is cited from the son of Maryam, Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, behold, your people, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam, cry out at that. They said that the Christians worship Jesus, so he is their God. Our gods are Hubal, Lat, Uzza, Manat. You have discarded them all. You say they are not, they have no existence. Nothing but your guesswork. But you are not saying anything against Jesus. This is, you know, their protest. Yes, it do. Then they cry. وَقَالُوا, and they say, أَعَالِهَتُنَا خَيْرٌ أَمْ هُوْ, are our gods better or he? مَا دَرَبُوهُ إِلَكَ إِلَّا جَدَلًا, and they have said this to you only for quarreling. بَلْ هُمْ قَوْمٌ خَسِمُونَ, they are a very quarrelsome people. إِنْ هُوَا إِلَّا عَبْدٌ أَنْعَمْنَا عَلَيْهِ, he was for us a servant and we blessed on him. وَجَعَلْنَاهُ مَسَلٍ لِبَنِي إِسْرَائِيلِ, and we have made him an example, a sign for the children of Israel. وَلَوْ نَشَاءُ لَجَعَلْنَا مِنْكُمْ مَلَائِكَةً فِي الْأَرْضِ يَخْلُفُونَ, and if we decide, we can make from you, come out from you, angels in this earth, in this world, and they will be successors. We can create anything out of anything. وَإِنَّهُ لَعِلْمٌ لِلسَّاعَةِ, and he, Isa alayhi salam, is a sign of the hour. This ayah is very important according to our ulama, that you know, among the important and big signs of the coming of near, of Qiyamah, of the Sa'ah, one is coming down of Jesus again. Nazul Masih alayhi salatu wasalam. Regarding that, there are very, very authentic ahadith, and many authentic ahadith. So it is a part of our creed, we believe, that Isa was not crucified, alayhi salatu wasalam. He was lifted alive to the heaven, and he will return from before the end of this world, and he will chastise the Jews, and he will kill the leader of Jews, Dajjal. He will kill him. And so, you know, the people who rejected him, he was sent as a messenger to the Jews, Rasulun ila Bani Israel, and they rejected him. So that punishment which has been due, now it's 2,000 years that it has been due. Now the time is very near when Jesus will come again, and he will punish, and all the Jews will be exterminated. وَإِنَّهُ لَعِلْمُ لِسَّاعَةِ فَلَا تَمْتَرُنَّ بِهَا, so you don't have any doubt about it. وَاتَّبُعُونِي هَذَا صِرَاطُ مُسْتَقِيمُ, and follow me. And this is the straight way. وَلَا يَسُدَّنَّكَ قَوْمُ الشَّيْطَانِ, and let not the Satan bar you. إِنَّهُ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌّ مُبِينٌ, let him not stop you from coming to the right path. Verily he is for you a clear and open enemy. وَلَمَّا جَاءَ عِيسَى بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ, and when Isa came with clear signs, the miracles of Hazrat Masih alayhi salam were the greatest. قَالَ لَقَدْ جَئْتُكُمْ بِالْحِكْمَةِ, he said, I have brought you the wisdom. This is very important. There is no law in Injil. Hazrat Isa said that the law of Moses, Sharia of Moses, is binding upon you also. That is why Injil doesn't contain any law. It's only wisdom, sermon. The Injil only tells the essence of deen, ruh-e deen, the essence of faith, iman, tawakkul on Allah, all these things, you know, they are discussed in Injil and the sermons of Hazrat Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, not the laws. Torah was law, book, and Injil is hikmah, wisdom. But in Quran, all these things have come together. It's a book, it's hikmah, everything. فلما جاء عيسى بالبينات, when Isa came to them with clear signs and miracles, قال قد جئتكم بالحكمة, he said, I have brought to you the wisdom. وليبين لكم بعض الذي تختلفون فيه, and so that I make clear to you some of those things in which you have been differing. فاتقوا الله واطيعون, so fear Allah and obey me. إن الله هو ربي وربكم, verily Allah is my Lord and your Lord. فاعبدوه, so worship him, obey him. هذا صراط مستقيم, this is the right path. فاختلف الأحزاب من بينهم, so different groups differed among themselves. فويل للذين ظلموا من عذاب يوم أليم, so woe be to those who did wrong things from the chastisement of a painful day. هل ينظرون إلى الساعة, what are they looking for except الساعة, the doomsday, the قيامة, أن تأتيهم بغتة, that it should come to them suddenly, وهم لا يشعرون, and they will have no perception that it's coming. الأخلاو يومئذ بعضهم لبعض عدو, all the friends on that day will become enemies to each other, إلا المتقين, except those who feared God. The muttaqeen, if they are friends here, they will remain friends in the hereafter also. But those who are not God-fearing, they have only their friendships for this world. So no, they will become enemies to each other on the day of judgment. يَا عِبَادِ لَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْكُمُ الْيَوْمْ وَلَا أَنْتُمْ تَحْزَنُونَ, O my servants, there is no fear upon you today. وَلَا أَنْتُمْ تَحْزَنُونَ, and nor you shall grieve. الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِآيَاتِنَا, those who believed in our revelations, وَكَانُوا مُسْلِمِينَ, and they surrendered themselves, submitted. اُدْخُلُوا الْجَنَّةِ, now enter paradise, enter the garden. أَنْتُمْ وَأَزْوَاجُكُمْ تُحْبَرُونَ, you and your spouses, you shall be delighted over there. يُطَافُ عَلَيْهِمْ بِصِحَافٍ مِنْ ذَهَبٍ وَأَكْوَابٍ, there shall be passed around them platters of gold and cups. وَفِيهَا مَا تَشْتَهِيهِ الْأَنفُسُ وَتَلَذُّ الْأَعْيُنُ, and in that garden there will be for them whatever their souls desire and the eyes delight in. وَأَنْتُمْ فِيهَا خَالِدُونَ, and now you will abide here forever, forever. وَتِلْكَ الْجَنَّةُ الَّتِي أُورِثْتُمُوهَا بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ, and this is the garden which you have been made to inherit because of what you used to do. لَكُمْ فِيهَا فَاكِهَةٌ كَثِيرَةٌ, now here for you are abundant fruit. مِنْهَا تَأْكُلُونَ, out of which you can eat. إِنَّ الْمُجْرِمِينَ فِي عَذَابِ جَهَنَّمَ خَالِدُونَ, on the contrary, the guilty, the culprits, they are in the chastisement of the hell, and they will abide there forever. لَا يُفَتَّرُ عَنْهُمْ وَهُمْ فِيهِ مُبْلِسُونَ, this chastisement of the hell will never be abated for them, and they shall be despaired therein. وَمَا ظَلَمْنَاهُمْ وَلَكِنْ كَانُوهُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ, and we never wronged to them, never done any, did any injustice to them, but they were doing wrong to themselves. وَنَادَوْا, and they will cry, يَا مَالِكُ, يَا مَالِكُ, he is the keeper of the paradise, of the hell. يَا مَالِكُ لِيَقْضِ عَلَيْنَا رَبُّكُ, let your Lord put an end to us. Let your Lord make us die, so that we are free from this affliction. يَا مَالِكُ لِيَقْضِ عَلَيْنَا رَبُّكُ, let him do away with us now. قَالَ إِنَّكُمْ مَاكِسُونَ, he will say, no, you have to remain here forever. No death will come to you to free you from this affliction. لَقَدْ جَيْنَاكُمْ بِالْحَقِّ, we brought you the truth. وَلَكِنْ أَكْسَرَكُمْ لِلْحَقِّ كَارِهُونَ, وَلَكِنَّ أَكْسَرَكُمْ لِلْحَقِّ كَارِهُونَ, but most of you, they were very averse to the truth. أَمْ أَبْرَمُوا أَمْرًا فَإِنَّا مُبْرِمُونَ, have they decided their affair? Okay, then we are also deciding. أَمْ يَحْسَبُونَ أَنْ لَا نَسْمَعُ سِرَّهُمْ وَنَجْوَاهُمْ, do they think that we don't listen their secrets and their private counselings and consultations? بَلَا, why not? We listen. And moreover, وَرُسُلُنَا لَدَيْهِمْ يَكْتُبُونَ, our agents are there who are writing down everything. قُلْ إِنْ كَانَ لِلرَّحْمَانِ وَلَدٌ فَأَنَا أَوَّلُ الْعَابِدِينَ, say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, If there was really a son to the compassionate, I would have been the first to worship him. Why should not I have worshipped him? If I worship Allah, if he had a son, I would have worshipped. If he had a daughter, I would have worshipped. But there is no daughter, no son. It's not for Allah to take a son to him. It not behoves of him. قُلْ إِنْ كَانَ لِلرَّحْمَنِ وَلَدٌ فَأَنَا أَوَّلُ الْعَابِدِينَ سُبْحَانَ رَبِّ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ رَبِّ الْعَرْشِ عَمَّا يَصِفُونَ. Glorified is the Lord of the heavens and the earth, and the Lord of the throne of power from all those things which they describe. فَذَرْهُمْ يَخُوذُوا وَيَلْعَبُوا. So leave them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Let them speak nonsense and let them play. حَتَّى يُلَاقُوا يَوْمَهُمُ الَّذِي يُوَعَدُونَ. Till they meet their day, the day about which they have been promised. وَهُوَ الَّذِي فِي السَّمَاءِ إِلَهٌ وَفِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَهٌ. And it is He who is the Lord in the heaven as well as in the earth. Now this ayah comes very close to that sentence of the Lord's prayers. You know, Thy kingdom come, Thy will be done on earth as it is in heavens. O Allah, Your will is being obeyed. Your commands are being obeyed in the whole of the universe. But there is only revolt here on this planet earth. So Your command should be established here also. Thy kingdom, kingdom of heaven or earth, the central theme of Hazrat Masih's, you know, call. Kingdom of heaven is coming. Kingdom of heaven is coming. So this kingdom of heaven doesn't mean He is the Lord of the heavens. His sovereignty should be established on this earth also. وَهُوَ الَّذِي فِي السَّمَاءِ إِلَهٌ وَفِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَهٌ وَهُوَ الْحَكِيمُ الْعَلِيمُ. And He is all wise, all knowing. وَتَبَارَكَ الَّذِي لَهُ مُلْكُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. And blessed is He to whom is the kingdom and sovereignty of all the heavens and the earth. وَمَا بَيْنَهُمَا. And whatever is between them. وَإِنْدَهُ إِلْمُ السَّاعَةِ. And the knowledge of that hour, that appointed hour, is with Him. وَإِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ. And to Him you will be turned back. وَلَا يَمْلِكُ الَّذِينَ يَدُونَ مِنْ دُونِهِ شَفَاعَةً. And those whom they are calling upon besides Allah, they will possess no power of intercession. إِلَّا مَنْ شَهِدَ بِالْحَقِّ وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ. Except those who will testify with truth and will they be knowing. They will say, okay, this person is really a guilty person. They won't say, you know, anything which is wrong. How can anybody say anything wrong in the presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? What about the angels, the prophets, the messengers, the saints? They will say anything wrong? No. They will say truth. Whatever truth, they will say it out. لَإِنْ سَأَلْتَهُمْ مَنْ خَلَقَهُمْ لَيَقُلُّنُ اللَّهِ. If you ask them, who created them? They will definitely say, Allah. فَأَنَّى يُفَكُونَ. So where from are they being deviated and diverted? وَقِيلَهِ. And I swear by the saying of the Prophet. What is the saying of the Prophet? يَا رَبَّ إِنَّ هَؤُلَاءِ قَوْمٌ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. Oh my Lord, this my people, they are a people who are not ready to believe. فَاسْفَحْ عَنْهُمْ. So O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, turn away from them for a while. وَقُلْ سَلَامٌ. And say salam, okay. You have rejected? Okay, go. فَسَوْفَ يَعْلَمُونَ. Very soon they will come to know as to what will be the result of their rejection. Surah Ad-Dukhan, as I told you, this is a pair, very beautiful pair. Surah Ad-Dukhan, Surah Ad-Dukhruf. This also states the same words. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Hameem wal-Kitab al-Mubeen. By the book, that is very self-evident and manifest. And I said, here we should read as understood. وَالْكِتَابِ الْمُبِينِ إِنَّكَ لَمِنَ الْمُرْسَلِينَ. This book, which is clear and self-evident, is enough proof that you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is a messenger of Allah. إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَاهُ فِي لَيْلَةٍ مُبَارَكَةٍ. Now the same thing which is said in the last part of Quran, Surah Al-Qadr, إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَاهُ فِي لَيْلَةِ الْقَدْرِ. important subjects are repeated in the Quran at least twice. Inna anzalnahu fi laylatil qadr, we send down this Quran in the laylatul qadr, the precious night. Here, inna anzalnahu fi laylatin mubarakatin, we sent it down in a night which was blessed. It is the same, not two of our nights, it's the same night in Ramadan, in the last 10 days. Inna kunna munzirin, verily, we have ever been warning. We have been sending our revelations to the messengers, so as to warn people. Fiha yufraqu kullu amrin hakeem. During that night, Laylatul Mubarakah or Laylatul Qadr, all the affairs of wisdom are decided and decreed and issued. This night for this world is a budget session of this divine kingdom. What will happen during this year? Who will die? Who will come and be born? What will happen to whom? What will happen to Pakistan? What will happen to this and that? These things are decided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this night. And this is called Laylatul Qadr. Tanazzalul malaikatu warruhu fiha bi'izni rabbihim min kulli amr. All the matters have been decided, and now the angels start coming down to implement those decisions that have been taken by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And here the word yufraqo is very important. Issued. Yufraqo, something separated. Now this order has been issued. Fiha yufraqo kullu amrin hakeem. All the important decisions are issued in this night. Amram min indina, as a command from us. Inna kunna mursaleen, verily, we have been the senders. Rahmatam min Rabbik. And we have been sending the messengers as a mercy from your Lord. Innahu huwa samiul alim. Verily, he is all listening, all knowing. Rabbi samawati wal ardi wa ma bainahuma in kuntum muqineen. He is the Lord of the heavens and the earth, and whatsoever is between them, in kuntum mu'mineen, if only you are convinced. La ilaha illa hu. There is no God except him. Yuhyi wa yumeet. He gives life and he puts to death. Rabbukum wa rabbu abaikum al-awwaleen. He is your Lord and the Lord of your forefathers. Balhum fi shaki al-abun. But these people, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they are in doubts and they are playing, mocking. فَرْتَقِبْ يَوْمَ تَعْتِ السَّمَاءُ بِدُخَانِ مُبِينَ. So you just wait and see when the heaven will bring a manifest smoke. Now in the coming ayat, there is a reference to a small chastisement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala which came to Makkah. As we read in Suratul Anam, Suratul Araf, then again in Suratul Sajda, it has been the practice of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that whenever he sent a messenger to a people, he sends small chastisement, small afflictions, so that if they are sleeping, they should wake up and they should think. So these small afflictions, they are not for the destruction, but only meant to open their eyes, if really they can open their eyes. If they are not already absolutely dead spiritually, then you know this thing will shake them up and they will rise and see the affairs. So this was in the form of a very big famine which came to Mecca and all the area around it. So due to this drought, you know, there was nothing to eat. People were hungry. And you know, in that condition, it seems as if, you know, there is dust all around in the atmosphere. Dukhani mubin. There is some smoke which is covering the heaven. So it is meant by this. فَرْتَقِبْ سُوَيْتْ O Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, for the day, يَوْمَ تَعْتِ السَّمَاءُ بِدُخَانِ مُبِينَ, when the heaven will bring a manifest smoke, يَقْشَ النَّاسِ, it will cover and envelop the people. هَذَا عَذَابٌ عَلِيمٌ, and this will be a painful chastisement. رَبَّنَا اكْشِفْ عَنَّا الْعَذَابِ إِنَّا مُؤْمِنُونَ. And they said and cried, O Allah, O our Lord, you just remove from us this chastisement. We come to believe, we shall believe. Anna lahum uzzikra. Where from can they have this admonition and reminding? Waqad jaahum rasulun mubeen. Although a clear messenger had come to them. He was reciting unto them the revelations of their Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They never came to believe. Now will they believe? أَنَّا لَهُمُ الزِّكْرَ وَقَدْ جَاءَهُمْ رَسُولٌ مُّبِينٌ ثُمَّ تَوَلَّوْا عَنْهُ. Then, but they just turned away from him. وَقَالُوا مُعَلَّمٌ مَجْنُونٌ. And they said, oh, he is a taught one. Somebody has taught him. He is getting dictation from somebody. Or he is a possessed one, مَجْنُونٌ. Or he has gone crazy. إِنَّا كَاشِفُ الْعَذَابِ قَلِيلًا إِنَّكُمْ عَائِدُونَ. Okay, we are going to remove this chastisement for a while. But we know that you will surely revert to your disbelief. يَوْمَ نَبْتَشُ الْبَقْسَةَ الْكُبْرَى. But when we shall seize them with the big seizure, عَذَابَ الْأَدْنَى and عَذَابَ الْأَكْبَرِ, we read in Surah Al-Sajdah, وَلَنُذِيقَنَّهُمْ مِنَ الْعَذَابِ الْأَدْنَى دُونَ الْعَذَابِ الْأَكْبَرِ. Now when we shall, يَوْمَ نَبْتَشُ الْبَقْسَةَ الْكُبْرَى, the bigger seizure, greatest seizure will come, إِنَّا مُنْتَقِمُونَ, then we shall take the revenge. وَلَقَدْ فَتَنَّا قَبْلَهُمْ قَوْمَ فِرْعَونَ. And in the same way, we had tried before them the people of Fir'aun, وَجَاهُمْ رَسُولٌ كَرِيمٌ. And to them, a very respectable Rasul, messenger had come. أَنْ أَدُّوا إِلَيَّ عِبَادَ اللَّهِ. And he has said to Fir'aun, now deliver to me the servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنِّي لَكُمْ رَسُولٌ أَمِينٌ. Surely I am for you a trustworthy messenger. وَاللَّهُ تَعَالُوا عَلَى اللَّهِ. And don't exalt yourselves against Allah. Don't revolt against Allah. إِنِّي آتِيكُمْ بِسُلْطَانِ مُبِينٍ. I have come to you with a clear authority. وَإِنِّي عُسْتُ بِرَبِّي وَرَبِّكُمْ أَتَرْجُمُونَ. And I take refuge with my Lord and your Lord, lest you should stone me to death. وَإِن لَمْ تُؤْمِنُوا بِي وَإِن لَمْ تُؤْمِنُوا لِي فَاعْتَزِلُونِ. But if you don't believe in me, then let me alone. Go away. Don't touch me with any evil design. فَدَعَ رَبَّهُ أَنَّ هَٰؤُلَاءِ قَوْمٌ مُجْرِمُونَ. Then he prayed to his Lord. These people are guilty people. They are culprits. They are not going to believe in us. فَأَسْرِ بِعِبَادِي لَيْلًا إِنَّكُمْ مُتَّبَعُونَ. Now the revelation was sent to him. You go forth with my people during the night. Surely you will be followed. وَاتْرُكِ الْبَحْرَ رَهْوَى. And when you have crossed the sea or the river, whatever it was, or the lake, one of the salt lakes, then leave it as calm and divided as it is. When you know Hazrat Musa struck the sea with his staff, it divided into two. كُلُّ فِرْقٍ كَالطَّوْدِ الْعَظِيمِ. And every side became just as a rock. But now Allah said, leave it as it is, so that when Fir'aun and his hosts and armies come, they'll be drowned. وَاتْرُكُ الْبَحْرَ رَهْوَى إِنَّهُمْ جُنْدٌ مُغْرَقُونَ. Now these hosts are going to be drowned. كَمْ تَرَكُوا مِنْ جَنَّاتٍ وَعُيُونَ. How many they left behind them, their gardens and their springs, وَزُرُوعٍ, and their sown fields, وَمَقَامٍ كَرِيمٍ, and their very beautiful dwellings, وَنَعْمَةٍ, and the delights, كَانُوا فِيهَا فَاكِهِينَ, in which they used to rejoice. كَذَلِكَ, it was like that. وَأَوْرَثْنَاهَا قَوْمًا آخَرِينَ. And this all we made other nation to inherit. They were drowned. Now the next generation or some or whosoever was there, they inherited them. فَمَا بَقَتْ عَلَيْهِمُ السَّمَاءُ وَالْأَرْضُ وَمَا كَانُوا مُنْظَرِينَ. So now on their fate, neither the heaven wept nor the earth, and nor they were given any respite. وَلَقَدْ نَجَّيْنَا بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ مِنَ الْعَذَابِ الْمُهِينَ. And we delivered Bani Israel, children of Israel, from the humiliating chastisement. مِنْ فِرْعَوْنَ, from Fir'aun. إِنَّهُ كَانَ عَالِيًا مِنَ الْمُسْرِفِينَ. Verily, he was from the prodigals, and surely he had become very much arrogant. وَلَقَدْ اخْتَرْنَاهُمْ عَلَىٰ عِلْمٍ عَلَىٰ الْعَالَمِينَ. And we chose them, the Bani Israel, the children of Israel, on the basis of our knowledge. We chose them above all the worlds. Now please note, twice in Surah Baqarah we have this ayah. Exactly. يَا بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ اذْكُرُوا نِعْمَتِيَ الَّتِي أَنْعَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ وَأَنِّي فَضَّلْتُكُمْ عَلَى الْعَالَمِينَ. O children's light, remember my blessings over you, and I raise you higher than all the nations of the world. These are Bani Israel. Here again we find, وَلَقَدْ أَخْتَرْنَاهُمْ, we have chosen them, عَلَىٰ عِلْمٍ, on the basis of our knowledge, عَلَىٰ الْعَالَمِينَ, above all the nations of the world. This nation has been, at least, believing in one God, has been throughout history, except a very small period when a section of these people, they declared Hazrat Uzair alayhi salam to be son of God. But though not all of Bani Israel, some of them, and for a very small period. Otherwise, Tawheed is with them. They never left Tawheed. They stuck to Tawheed throughout history. This is something. And this is the nation only who has a recorded history of 5,000 years. No other nation in the world has that history. People don't know where from we had come. You ask somebody, he doesn't know even the name of his grandfather. I ask, you know, people in Pakistan, where from your brother, your father's, your parents, you know, migrated to Pakistan. They said, somewhere in India, we don't know. They don't know where they belonged and where the forefather had come there from. No. But this is a nation. It has a written, recorded history. And that history is by and large confirmed by Quran. Quran refers to that history. All these, you know, the prophets of the Old Testament who were caught, we accept that they were the prophets, no doubt. Except for Hud and Saleh. They are not mentioned. Because they were not in the line of Ibrahim. It was a separate batch of the progeny of Sam. And they were very far off from them. In southern Arabian Peninsula and Qawm Aad. So they are not mentioned in Torah, in the Old Testament. But all the others are mentioned. وَلَقَدْ اِخْتَرْنَاهُمْ عَلَىٰ عِلْمٍ عَلَىٰ الْعَالَمِينَ, I have said so. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, having given this status to a nation, then He gave them the punishment first. ضُرِبَتْ عَلَيْهِمُ الزِّلَّةُ وَالْمَسْكَنَةُ, we heaped upon them the zillah, the humility, and maskana. Why? فَبَعُوا بِغَضَبِ مِنَ اللَّهِ, and they got the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? An ummah which has the book of Allah, which is the custodian of the law of Allah, becomes the representative of Allah on earth. And now if by its action it misrepresents Allah, it's bigger criminal than the kuffar. This is a very bitter truth. I wanted to bring it home to you. Why are we being humiliated? Why? The same law. We are the custodians of the book of Allah. We are the custodians of divine Sharia. We say we are the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But where is Deen? The Prophet said sallallahu alaihi wasallam in one of his ahadith, "Yushik wa yati ala nas zamanun, la yabqa min al-Islam illa smuhu, wa la yabqa min al-Quran illa rasmuhu." I fear a time will come when there will not remain nothing from Islam except its name. And there will remain nothing of Quran except the script. Rasmuhu, Rasmul Khat. That's. We are very much in that time. And that is why we are being persecuted. We are being punished. It's divine punishment. Coming at the hands of the enemies, but not without the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَآتَيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْآيَاتِ مَا فِيهِ بَلَاءٌ مُبِينٌ, and we gave them our signs in which there was a clear trial and examination for them. إِنَّ هَؤُلَاءِ لَيَقُولُونَ, surely these people are saying, إِنْ هِيَ إِلَّا مَوْتُتُنَا الْأُولَىٰ وَمَا نَحْنُ بِمُنْشَرِينَ, this is only one death of ours which will come to us, and then we shall not be raised again. Denying this resurrection and the hereafter. فَاتُوا بِآبَائِنَا إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ, if you are true, then bring back our forefathers. If they can be resurrected, if they can bring forth our forefathers before us, then we shall believe that yes, we will also be resurrected. Ahum khairun al qawm al-tubba. Are they better? Or the people of Tubba? Tubba, you know, they were the kings of Saba in Yemen. Just as, you know, the title of the kings of Egypt was Fir'aun. Title of the kings in Chaldea or Iraq was Nimrod. The title of the kings of Yemen was Tubba. وَالَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ And those who were before them, أَهْلَكْنَاهُمْ We destroyed them. إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا مُجْرِمِينَ Verily, they were guilty. This nation was in power in Yemen from the year 150 BC, before Christ, to the year 300 AD. For 450 years, they were the rulers in Yemen. فَمَا خَلَقْنَا سَمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ وَمَا بَيْنَهُمَا لَاعِبِينَ And we have not created the heavens and the earth and what is in between them, playing. وَمَا خَلَقْنَاهُمَا إِلَّا بِالْحَقِّ We have not created them, but with a certain purpose. وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَهُمْ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ But most of them know not. إِنَّ يَوْمَ الْفَصْلِ مِيقَاتُهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ Definitely the day of decision, the day of judgment, is the appointed time for all of them. يَوْمَ لَا يُغْنِي مَوْلًا عَنْ مَوْلًا شَيْئًا When the day when no friend will be of any avail to his friend, وَلَهُمْ يُنْسَرُونَ And they will not be helped. إِلَّا مَنْ رَحِمَ اللَّهِ Except the one whom Allah shows His mercy. إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْعَزِيزُ الرَّحِيمُ Verily, He is all-powerful and He is the merciful. إِنَّ شَجَرَةَ الزَّقُّومِ Verily, the tree of Zakkum, تَعَامُ الْأَسِيمُ It will be the food of the sinful sinners in the hell. كَالْمُهْلْ يَغْلِي فِي الْبُطُونِ And it will boil like molten brass in their bellies. كَغَلْيِ الْحَمِيمِ Just as a boiling water seethes. خُزُوهُ And then it will be said, seize him. فَعْتَلُوهُ إِلَىٰ سَبَعِ الْجَحِيمِ And then drag him into the midst, in the middle of the hellfire. ثُمَّ صُبُّوا فَوْقَ رَاسِهِ مِنْ عَذَابِ الْحَمِيمِ Then you pour upon his head the chastisement of boiling water. زُقْ Taste it. إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَزِيزُ الْكَرِيمِ Actually, you were powerful. You held power. You were a king. You were Fir'aun. You were Tubba. You were Nimrod. Now taste. You are the all-powerful. And respectful and noble. In hada ma kuntum bihi tamtaroon. Now this is what you were doubting about. Innal muttaqina fi maqamin ameen. Whereas the people who had fear of Allah in their hearts, they will be in a very peaceful place. Fi jannatin wa uyun. In gardens and springs. Yalbasuna min sundusin wa istabraqin mutaqabilin. Dressed in silk and brocade. Facing one another. Kazalik. Thus it shall be. وَزَوَّجْنَاهُمْ بِهُورٍ عِينٍ And we shall espouse them to wide-eyed houris. يَدْعُونَ فِيهَا بِكُلِّ فَاكِدٍ آمِنِينَ They will be ordering there all the fruits without any fear. There will be no fear that will be said, this fruit is not available. No. Whatever you call, it will be brought before you. لا يذوقون فيها الموت إلا الموتة الأولى. Now they are not going to taste another death, except the death through which they have already come. وَبَقَاهُمْ عَذَابَ الْجَحِيمِ And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has saved them, will save them from the chastisement of the hellfire. فَضْلًا مِنْ رَبِّكَ And it will be a bounty from your Lord. ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْفَوْضُ الْعَظِيمِ And verily, this will be the mighty triumph, the real success. فَإِنَّمَا يَسَّرْنَاهُ بِلِسَانِكَ O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so we have made this Qur'an very easy in your language, in your tongue. لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَذَكَّرُونَ So that they might be admonished, they might be reminded of the basic realities of this universe. فَارْتَقِبْ إِنَّهُمْ مَرْتَقَبُونَ So wait, O Prophet, for the end, Allah's command. Surely, they too are waiting. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar.
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations, first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about IONA, please visit us at www.tanzeem.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us or call our toll-free number 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together, we can make a difference.